Hi, everybody. I've been asked to talk a little bit about this past year's youth convention and looking forward to this coming year's youth convention. I'm happy to do so because this past year, as you know, was the first opportunity I've had to attend a youth convention here in the Archdiocese of Seattle. I have to tell you that I was very impressed from start to finish in the different things that I participated in. The theme that was given this past year, preparing the journey to the heights, was one that was particularly important for me personally. And the reason is that for a long time, I've had devotion to Blessed Pier Giorgio Frassati. I first learned about him back in the 1970s when I was a seminarian in Italy, and that's when, at that time, they were promoting the cause of his beatification. So I was able to learn a lot about him right there in Italy, where he grew up and where he had lived and where his presence was so real even today. And so ever since then, ever since the mid-70s, I've kind of followed the process of his beatification. And so the fact that that was the chosen theme, something taken from his own life, was a great joy for me personally. One of the things that Frassati had said was that when we live by our faith and take it seriously, that it changes our life totally. And he was an example of that by the way that he lived, by the way that he treated other people, by the way that he looked after the poor, by the way he saw reality and even government. He understood that we had to live our Christian faith to the full in every aspect of our life. That other part of the theme, to the heights, was taken from something that he wrote on the very last photograph taken of him when he was climbing a mountain. It wasn't too long before he died. And so he liked the photograph so much, it was a picture of him literally climbing up the mountain, rappelling himself off with a rope. And he wrote, verso l'alto in Italian, which means to the heights. And after he died, that became sort of a motto of his life, because that's what he tried to do, to live his life always in the direction of God. I think this past year that Daniel and Diana did a superb job leading us off and being the MCs for the entire youth convention. And I think they brought a real enthusiasm to those who were there, including myself. I was impressed with the fact that there were 1,500 young people from all over the Archdiocese and even from Canada who had joined us that day. And having had the chance to speak to lots and lots of youth from around this area, I saw how much alive the faith is in this part of our country and particularly in this Archdiocese, and it gave me great hope for the future. Just to be with that many young people who are enthused about their Catholic faith has a very strong effect on you. It's for that reason that I want to encourage all of you to come to this year's youth convention. I promise you that you'll have a wonderful experience of faith, a wonderful experience of being part of something much larger than you, the Catholic Church, as you'll meet new friends who share your faith, and you'll also find that the various workshops, the times of prayer, and most especially our celebration of Mass together will help you to be an even stronger Catholic and help you to recognize that you're not in this alone. All of us together are part of the Catholic Church, and all of us together live and proclaim the good news, who is Jesus Christ. That's what Frassati taught us, and that's what we'll keep doing in the Archdiocese. So I encourage you to come, and I hope to see you there.